Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, let's see how to group and filter the items of view drop-down list of Synfusion. If you look at this online example, you can see the drop-down list displaying different book names. These books are grouped under different categories like comics, science fiction, and thriller. You can also filter the specific book names that matches your typed-in characters. I will show you now how to group and filter the drop-down list items using my Getting Started application. Let me open my existing View application where I have added the View drop-down list with remote data. If you want to know how to create a simple View drop-down list, then you can listen to my Getting Started video, the link for which is shown in the above YouTube card. Also, you can download this Getting Started example from the GitHub link, which I have shared in the description part below. Now, to have better clarity and focus on these grouping and filtering features, I am replacing the remote data with JSON data collection, which contains an array of objects with two fields, namely name and ID. Also, I have mapped the name field to text property and ID field to value property. I have assigned vegetable names to data source, so let me change the placeholder property value as select a vegetable. Also, ensure whether this data item and data fields variables are assigned to the data source and fields property of the drop-down list. So here, you can see the drop-down list showing vegetable names. Now, let me show you the steps to group these drop-down list items. For that, I will open the app.view file first. And here, I need to define one more field category with appropriate values on each object of the existing data source. Then, I will map this newly defined data source field name category to the group by option within the fields property of the drop-down list component. As the data item and data fields variables are already assigned to the data source and fields property of the drop-down list, so let me show you the output directly. Now, when you look at the drop-down list, the data items are grouped under the category leafy and salad and beans. Next, I'm going to show you how to filter the data items on the drop-down list based on the characters I type on the search box. To start filtering the data items, first, I need to enable the filtering feature in drop-down. For that, let me define the property AllowFiltering and set its value as true inside the drop-down list code. Look at the drop-down list now. When I start to type in some characters here, you can see the pop-up displaying the vegetable names that starts with my typed-in text. You can notice here, by default, the casing of the typed-in characters are ignored during the filtering action on drop-down. But if I want to consider the characters with same casing as I type in, then I need to set false to the ignore case property. So here, you can see the drop-down list. When I start to type in some characters in lower case, then you can see the drop-down list with no records due to the casing mismatch. Next, let me proceed to explain about the filter types of drop-down. By default, starts with filter type is applied while filtering the data items on drop-down, but you can also filter the drop-down list items based on the other two filter types, namely ends with or contains. Now, I will proceed to filter the items based on the end characters of data items. So, I will define the property filter type and set its value as ends with inside the drop-down list code. And if I type in some characters here, you can see the pop-up showing vegetable names that ends with my typed-in characters. Similarly, you can also apply contains filter type if you want to filter the data items that contains your typed-in characters at any of the position. Finally, let me proceed to show you how to do filtering with diacritics characters in the text. Usually, When I try to filter the items that has some diacritic characters, it will be ignored during filtering. To show you the working of diacritics filtering, first, let me modify the data source with some diacritic characters. Then, I will define the property ignore accent inside the dropdown list code and set its value as true. Here, I have assigned array of strings to dropdown list data source, so I will remove the fields property of dropdown list code. Now, when you look at this dropdown list, you can see the pop-up displaying the filtered data items that has the diacritic characters in it. Okay, let me summarize some of the important points now. We have seen how to group the view dropdown list items as well as how to filter those items. Also, we have seen the supported filter types in dropdown list and how to apply those filters as well as how to include diacritics characters while filtering. If you would like to see the working of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link which is shared in the description part below. Also, if you find this video as useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos. Thanks for watching this video.